So the next cooperative learning type of group I'd like to talk about is formal groups. Informal groups can take on many different forms, so to speak, and I think the nice thing I like about using formal groups in class is they more closely really emulate kind of working teams that STEM professionals work on, whether they're going to go on academic tracks or non-academic tracks. These could be often structured as a kind of stakeholder groups addressing an academic controversy. They could be groups associated with analysis and management teams. You might be working on formal groups for different project presentations, or maybe group exams, or maybe just reviewing and correcting homeworks assignments. So the way formal groups work is, like any good pedagogy, is we have to make sure we're specifying specific objectives. We have to make sure students are comfortable with, and we have to enable them in terms of how they're going to make decisions to move the group forward to be productive. Make sure that we as the instructor explain the task, check for understanding that students understand the task, built in positive interdependence. That was one of our key principles of cooperative learning in terms of what are each individual going to contribute, and the fact that the group as a whole can't succeed without individual contributions and group accountability in terms of the products that you want students to develop. You as the instructor, once you make the assignment, can't walk away from it. A critical part of what we as professors have to do is monitor and manage our teams and intervene occasionally to teach the students perhaps some of the skills that are going to help them succeed in having a good teamwork experience and have a successful product. So things that I work with my own students on before they start their formal group activities is provide them some background on how they're going to set expectations and resolve conflicts if they arise in their groups, and how they're going to manage their groups in terms of communications, in terms of timelines, etc. And last of all is we as instructors have to explain and build in how we're going to evaluate students' achievements, both as individuals as well as group productivity and their accomplishments. And I would recommend doing that periodically throughout the time period in which you're having formal groups work. And this is where the intervening comes in. You have to You have to frequently touch base with your groups to see that they're moving forward. So one example of a formal group that I've used in my own classes is with academic controversies. And with academic controversies, this is a pedagogy where students are presented a problem or an issue that's very complex. I provide them relevant information to help them make decisions, and academic controversies at the very least usually have two stakeholder groups or two viewpoints, so to speak, on a controversy. This example that I'm showing here is the management of wildlife and natural resources at the Maasai Mara National Park in Kenya. And in this particular case, I like to use three stakeholder groups: a tour group company that has economic and ecotourism interest, the Kenya Wildlife Service, which is the professionals in Kenya that are responsible for wildlife conservation, and then some local farmers and landowners that are concerned with crop damages and wildlife interactions. So in this formal activity, formal cooperative group activity, in doing role playing and using the information that you provide, or information that you expect students to research and gather and synthesize is that they collectively work together in a multidisciplinary team to come up with the best solution to address a particular controversy and justify that approach and present that to the class both orally, occasionally have students write reports or essay type exam questions. The outcomes of this and what we tell students at the end is that even though groups prepare persuasive arguments and presentations, is that individual accountability comes in, is that you have individuals that have to role play one of these three stakeholder groups. And they have to be able to communicate the relevant information associated with their stakeholder group. So now that we've talked a bit about formal groups, what we'd like you to do is, again, pick a topic, a concept, or a principle in your own discipline. Think about a learning objective that you could have for learning that respective topic, concept, or principle. What's a cooperative learning assignment that you could use using formal groups to support that objective? And we'd like you to post that on the discussion forum. And again, in keeping with good practice, think about Bloom's taxonomy when developing that objective. What's measurable? What level of learning do you want students to be engaged in? And make sure the expectations for the formal cooperative learning group is in alignment with what your learning objective is.